welcome and good morning, everyone. Woo! My name is Heather Mathis. I'm the VN Assistant Program Coordinator here at Guernica Academy's Fresno campus. I am so honored to be your Master of Ceremony for today's Vocational Nurse Pinning Ceremony. Please stand with us for the national anthem. You please be seated. This morning, I would first like to welcome our esteemed guests, faculty, family, and friends. Thank you all for joining us as we celebrate the perseverance, hard work, and accomplishments of our nursing students. This is a joyous moment for our students, their family, friends, and all of us here at Guernica. Seeing graduates, families, friends, staff and faculty here today is a testament to the achievements of the graduates and the love and support they have received over the months they have studied and learned with us. Today is the fun part, for sure. Over the past few months, we've seen the graduates work exceptionally hard. The staff and faculty remember when you first began your Guernica experience. We are blessed to have had the privilege of helping you with your educational growth. The nursing pin and accompanying ceremony represents an eloquent experience for our nursing students. It symbolizes the completion of educational requirements that enables nurses to sit for the state licensure examination and enter the nursing profession. At this time, we would like to recognize the students that put forth constant efforts of persevering through the most difficult times in the hopes of a better future. We are honored to present them with the Perseverance Award. Students, as I call your name, please come forward to accept the Perseverance Award. Anahi Islasrico. Congratulations. Ruben Valencia. Congratulations. We would also like to recognize some of our students who have gone above and beyond during their nursing program and have exceeded expectations. These students are recognized for their exceptional clinical performance and demonstration of caring practices to their patients and peers. We are honored to present them with the Spirit of Nursing Award. Students, as I call your name, please come forward to accept the Spirit of Nursing Award. Guadalupe Brito Aguilar. Congratulations. Angelina Booker. Congratulations. This award is given to nurses for exceptional courage and devotion to the wounded or sick. These students showed excellence in the clinical setting. These students were recognized by staff and, most importantly, provided kind and competent care. This is truly the highest international distinction a nurse can achieve. Thank you, students, for your dedication to the nursing profession. At this time, we would like to continue our time-honored tradition and publicly recognize our graduating veterans and active duty personnel in recognition of their service to our country. Veteran students, please stand. Brenda Prince served in the Navy, Emelina Oblander in the Army. We have two faculty personnel as well. Ms. V.D. Flanagan served in the Navy, and Mr. Derek Brown served in the Army. Thank you all. We would like to ask all graduating active duty military personnel and student veterans who have served our country to please stand and be recognized. If you're in the audience as well and you have served, we would like to recognize you. We thank you for serving in the United States Army, United States Marine Corps, United States Navy, United States Air Force, United States Coast Guard, United States Public Health Services Commissioned Corps, and National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration Commissioned Officer Corps. Please give them a big round of applause, as I know you've already done, but we really thank you for your service. We will now begin our pinning ceremony. The nurse pinning ceremony is a symbolic welcoming of newly graduated nurses into the profession. Today on stage, we have our cohorts from VN 46, 47, 48, and 49. Representing our faculty, we have Mr. Brown and Ms. V.D. Flanagan. They're going to be helping us in pinning our students this morning. As a special treat, we are also going to allow the students to thank you, their support, their loved ones, and you who have really helped to get them through nursing school when they're up here getting pinned. So students, please rise and come forward to receive your pins. Lakeisha Mitchell.
First and foremost, I want to give thanks to God and my family and friends for the love and the support. Thank you so much.
Angelina Booker. Amanda Crawford.
Can you guys hear me? I wrote it down. So I would like to give God the glory and then give a huge thanks to my son Diego and Michael for allowing me to cuss them out almost every day before I studied, and then to always, and for them always having my back, and then for my parents for believing in me, encouraging me, and watching my two little kids.
Brenda Prince. Alondra Castanon. Harpinder Carr. Ashley Flores.
First and foremost, I want to thank God for paving the way and helping me get through this journey. I would also like to thank my son Mason for being so understanding for so many cereal dinners when I had a lot going on. And last, I want to thank my family who believed in me and encouraged me to believe in myself. Soon we will embark yet another journey, and once again, with the encouragement and assistance of our loved ones, we'll tell ourselves, I got this. And in closing, I want to say my mom is my biggest role model. Okay, mom, I said it. Where's my $100?
Kiara Vences.
I want to give a big thank you to my lovely parents, my family, my boyfriend, and his family for being my biggest support system through my nursing school journey, always believing in me and pushing me to never give up, and to my best friend for all those late night study dates that kept me going.
Avdeep Dillon. Regina Ornelas. Alyssa Gonzalez. Mahogany Henley.
They say success isn't achieved without the help of others. So I'd like to thank my family, my friends, classmates, and the teachers at Gurnett. Thank you.
Ruben Valencia.
Thank you to all my family for all of their support throughout my journey in nursing school. My beautiful mother, Ada, my little brother, Jaden, and my supportive father, Ruben. Thank you also to my best friend, Sam, for attending today. I would not be able to achieve my dream of becoming a nurse without all of you putting up with me in the morning before I had my coffee. Love, Jordan.
Aaliyah White.
I would like to thank God, my family, and my friends.
Jessica Ramirez.
I would like to say thank you to my family for loving me and supporting me throughout this roller coaster of a journey. I couldn't have done it without you all. Mom, Dad, I'm beyond blessed to have you as my parents, and I hope I made you proud.
Karina Valenzuela.
I'd like to thank my grandfather, Jose Montes. Thank you to Parvinder and Rajvinder Samra. Thank you to my biggest supporters, my parents, Jose and Monica Valenzuela, and the love of my life, Sukhjeet. You have always been right behind me every step of the way, through the ups, the ugly, and the crazy emotional outbursts. I love you, and thank you to the amazing friends and future nurses that I've made along the way. Thank you.
Anahi Islas.
I can't.
You got this. You got this.
Can you read it for me?
Yeah. First off, I'd like to thank God for allowing me to be here today. A special thank you to every teacher that's helped me throughout this journey, and my family has always supported me become who I am today. My journey does not end today. It is only just the beginning.
Guadalupe Ramirez.
Good morning. I want to say a special thanks to my parents, my family, and friends for all the love and support. To my children, Ernesto, Joanna, Giselle, Janelle, Isaac, and to my husband, Juan. You guys are my inspiration, my motivation, I could not have done it without you guys. And I want to say something in Spanish to my parents. Para mis padres que están aquí presentes, gracias y Dios me los bendiga.
Karina Limon.
Quería pedirle gracias a toda mi familia, a mis amigos que hicieron eso posible. Sin ellos, es muy duro para terminar esta carrera. Y gracias, muchas gracias, y los quiero mucho. And I wanted to thank my family and friends for being able to go through this hard, hard journey with us. And, you know, not having a life and being okay with it. So I love you guys, and thank you.
Brianna Sanchez.
Most importantly, I'd like to thank God and my biggest motivation, my children, and my mom for being my biggest supporter, and my siblings for always being there for me when I need them. Thank you.
Janelle Sarabia.
Okay, from the bottom of my heart, I want to thank my amazing parents for helping out me out with the kids every day, because I know that's hard. A big thank you to my husband for the support and for pushing me to get through this past year and constantly reminding me to strive for excellence. To my babies for being that motivation for me and to do better. I love you all. Thank you.
Judith Palomares.
I want to give a special thank you to my two wonderful boys, Michael Arellano and Aaron Arellano, for supporting me and always being here with me when I had to stay up late at night. And I want to give a special thank you to my mom. Ama, gracias por siempre estar ahí conmigo y siempre estar a mi lado con mis hijos. And a special thank you to my sister for riding along with me. Thank you.
Valerie Rivera.
I just want to say thank you to my family for all their love and support through this journey. I couldn't have done it without you all. I love you.
Good job.
Yuriko Palomares.
Le quiero dar gracias a mi mom. Y a mi esposo y a mis hijos, thank you so much. And for my brothers and nephews, I hope you guys do more than this.
Magdalucia Velasquez.
I would like to thank my parents, especially my mother.
All right, I'll start to begin. I'd like to thank my parents, especially my mother and my heavenly grandma for being my strength and inspiration throughout this journey. To my daughters, who are constant motivation, my partner, my family, and my best friend, thank you for all your support, and I couldn't have done this without you. Thank you.
Shelby Cronister.
I
would like to thank my family, my classmates, and all my teachers, and especially my daughter, for motivating me to start this journey in the first place. Thank you.
Kaseya Lewis.
Thank you to my husband for believing in me, to my mom, thank you for being my strength and inspiration, to my best friend, thank you for joining me on this journey, to my baby, Kaysen, I owe this to you and much more. I love you guys.
Yeah.
Jennifer Farias.
I would like to say thank you to my husband and my mom for all their help.
Jazz Kirk Carr. Lily Vang.
Thank you to my family and my boyfriend for all their support throughout this journey. One specific person I would love to thank is Ms. Gernick is Ms. Odlin. I can't read it either. You were a one-of-a-kind instructor that I became truly close with. I hope you're smiling and doing better up there in heaven.
Satinder G. Carr.
I want to say thank you, my family, my all family member, and all my classmates. Thank you.
Suk G. Carr.
I would like to thank my family and my classmates for always supporting each other and pushing each other to finish the program and get it over with. And we right here, thanks for always being there for each one of us and always supporting us. Thank you.
Rupinder Kaur. Amandeep Kaur.
I would like to thank my family, my friends, and my teacher, of course, who guided me and supported me throughout this journey. I'm so grateful. Thank you.
Oscar Uribe.
I'd like to thank my wife, my kids for being so supportive. It was not easy nights. Thank you for your patience. I thank God, most of all, my mom, my dad, my sisters for supporting me, and it's been tough. Thank you.
Emelena Oblander.
Thank you, Mom and Dad, for teaching me that hard work and perseverance is key. My husband for working selfless and working endless hours and all those nights alone with the kids. Helix and Zachariah, things got hard, but you stepped up to help watch your siblings. Christina, no matter the time or day, you always provided a listening ear and encouragement. Thank you, guys.
Zua Lohr.
First and foremost, I want to thank the Greenwich staff for teaching everything I need to know to become a nurse. And yeah, I guess every single day I tell myself in my head, okay, I want to quit, but I never say it out loud. I'm just really proud of myself for being here and finishing. And I want to thank my family and my brother for coming today.
Melissa Ortiz.
I want to thank my family and friends for your words of encouragement throughout my journey. My parents for showing me that nothing in life is handed, and if I want something, I must work hard for it. My babies for being my motivation. This is for you.
Kania Vang.
I would like to thank you to my mom and my husband for supporting me, and to my sister for believing me, and last for my cousin Sandy Yang for the biggest support and helping me through the school, and now we're graduating together. Thank you.
Jeanette Gavin Williams.
And thank you to my family, James, our girls, and my dad for your patience, love, and understanding, for always encouraging me to do my best and pushing me forward. I know you have my back because I have yours. I love you all from the stars to the moon.
Sandy Yang.
This past year has been a very challenging year for all of us, and even more challenging taking on this program. I would like to thank my families and friends for their support, understanding through this journey. To my husband Paul and son Toby, words cannot express how much I appreciate the sacrifice you have made so I can be where I am today. Thank you, and I love you.
Monica Morales.
I want to say thank you to God. Without him, this could not be possible. I want to say thank you to my children, Savannah, Jeffrey, and Eden, my husband, and my parents for all your sacrificing to help me keep my dreams come true. Thank you to my family and friends for being my biggest fans and never letting me quit. I could not have done this without you, and I am forever grateful. Thank you to Ms. Hayes for being our instructor for all four modules, even though she wasn't supposed to. Thank you, Gernick.
Carmen Ornelas.
I want to thank my husband. I love you. I want to thank mis papás. Los quiero mucho. Mis suegros. And most of all, my brother. I love you so much.
Anmol Samra.
I'd like to say thank you to my family for the unconditional love and support. A special thanks to my grandpa in heaven, who is not able to be here with us, but this was his biggest dream. Thank you to Carmen and Monica for being there for me at my lowest and highest. And another special thank you to Zaravar and Kirpa for being the people I look forward and being the future. God bless.
Kaylee Edmonds. Alyssa Mina. Sitley Almarez.
To my family and friends, I would like to thank you so much for your constant support throughout my journey at Gurnick Academy. I am thankful for each and every one of you. Without you, my journey would not be complete. I love and appreciate you all.
Rupinder Carr.
I would like to say thank you to my family, especially my husband. Thank you for always being there for me. Thank you for all your support. Without you, I could not get through the hard times. Thank you.
Anna Marquez.
I like to take the time to thank my three kids. Davian, thank you for being my taxi driver when I needed to study. And Ricky, thank you for taking over and cooking all the time. Hennessy, thank you for making sure I always had my coffee and my meals for work. And special thank you to Ruby, thanks for coming out here and supporting me. And to my kids, once again, thank you for making such a life change and allowing us to move to Fresno and allowing me to make this happen. Thank you. Oh, one more thing. And Mr. Brown for giving me all my gray hairs.
Moses Vargas.
To my family and friends, thank you for your unwavering love and support. Especially thanks to my fiance. I know you made a lot of sacrifices, but this is for us. Love you guys.
Monique Foster. Guadalupe Brito Aguilar.
Hello, everyone. I just wanted to say thank you to my family and my boyfriend, Ozzy, for always being my number one supporter and always sticking through me, being my ride or die. I wanted to say thank you to Gurnick and to the staff and all the teachers. You know, we went through this program in the midst of a pandemic, and we did it and rolled with the punches. I'm just really grateful for this program and all the people that I got to meet in this program. I can definitely say that I made friendships. I would like to give a shout out and some love to my work wifeys, for Jen and Shelby. Those were my girls. And thank you to, you know, again, all the teachers, Mr. Brown, thank you for always having some jokes in the beginning of the class. You know, they didn't go unnoticed. You always cracked some jokes. Thank you for Ms. Cabrera for everything. And Ms. Demery, Ms. Hayes, Ms. Mathis, everyone, thank you again. And I hope all the graduates have a wonderful day today. Thank you for all being here and supporting us.
Thank you to our staff, faculty, and all supporters in the audience for being a part of the vocational nurse pinning ceremony today. I know it was difficult for some of our graduates to verbally say thank you, but I know in their hearts they definitely mean it, and I'm sure this evening you will definitely hear it from them. So thank you for being present. Next, we will lead our students in the Florence Nightingale Pledge. The Nightingale Pledge has been a long-standing tradition at nurse pinning ceremonies. The heart of the pledge is an adaptation of the Hippocratic Oath taken by doctors. The pledge delineates the ethics that will be followed upon entering the nursing profession. Professional nursing includes the protection, promotion, and optimization of health, alleviation of suffering, and advocacy in the care of individuals, families, communities, and populations. The Nightingale Pledge encompasses the obligation to provide equal treatment in care, moral standards, nursing that promotes advocacy above obedience, and today's standards of nursing care. It is important to know who Florence Nightingale is so we can understand why we have a pledge dedicated in her honor. We have a short video talking about her contributions to the development of the nursing profession.
Florence Nightingale was a pioneer of public health and the founder of modern nursing.
Because of Florence Nightingale, nursing is one of the most regulated and respected professions in the world.
Named after her city of birth, Florence, Italy, Florence Nightingale was born on May 12, 1820, into an upper-class British family.
As a woman of her time and her class, it would have been expected that she would marry, maintain a lovely home, and be a hostess. But Florence Nightingale had very different plans. Though at the time nursing was not a respected profession, Nightingale felt very called to become a nurse.
At age 24, Nightingale defied her parents' expectations to marry a suitable match and left England to study at the Kaiserswerth Hospital in Dusseldorf, Germany.
When she returned from Germany, she took a job as a nurse at a hospital in London, and she was eventually promoted after only a year to be head of nursing there.
She improved sanitary conditions so much that she garnered a reputation as a reformer and as an advocate for public health.
During the Crimean War, the British press made public the horrendous conditions of the wounded soldiers in Turkey. The army turned to Florence Nightingale for help.
Sidney Herbert, Secretary at War, reached out directly to Nightingale. When Nightingale and her band of nurses arrived at Scutari, the hospital in the Crimea, they were shocked at what they found.
The field hospitals were positioned on cesspools of putrid water. Patients were lying in their filth. More soldiers were dying from infections than they were from wounds sustained on the battlefield.
Many of the reforms that Florence Nightingale instituted were quite revolutionary. Nightingale insisted that there be fresh air and water for all the soldiers, that recuperating soldiers receive healthy food to eat to help make them better, and that all of the bandages and sheets and blankets were adequately laundered each day.
By the time she was done, Florence Nightingale had succeeded in reducing the death rate within these military hospitals by 2/3.
Known as the Angel of the Crimea, Nightingale returned to England and received a hero's welcome, a medal from Queen Victoria, and a gift of $250,000. She devoted the rest of her life to effecting change in medical care.
In 1860, Florence Nightingale founded at St. Thomas Hospital in London the Nightingale Training School for Nurses.
She was a pioneer in the use of cutting-edge statistical methods of the time to design hospitals and medical systems to maximize the health of the community at large.
This really helped her to make her message known to the parliamentarians and government agencies who would make important decisions about hospitals and healthcare.
In her later years, Nightingale was officially honored by Germany, France, Norway, and numerous prestigious British societies. She died at her London home on August 13, 1910.
The fact that we have a nursing profession today is in large part thanks to the work of Florence Nightingale.
For those of you in the audience who have received pins and have dedicated yourself to the nursing profession, I ask that you nurture these students and impart knowledge to help them succeed. I would like to invite those of you who are nurses to stand with us together as we recite the time-honored tradition of the Nightingale Pledge. Please stand with us. We will now recite the Nightingale Pledge. I solemnly pledge myself before God and in the presence of this assembly to pass my life in purity and to practice my profession faithfully. I will abstain from whatever is deleterious and mischievous. I will not take or knowingly administer any harmful drug. I will do all in my power to maintain and elevate the standard of my profession. And I will hold in confidence all personal matters committed to my keeping. With loyalty will I endeavor to aid the physicians in their work and devote myself to the welfare of those committed to my care. Thank you, please be seated. Every day, nurses bring innovation, creativity, and healing touch to change patients' lives and the world. Throughout history, nurses have profoundly changed human health, and that changes everything. Throughout this journey, our students have shared many memories, not only with us, but together. And a slideshow has been created to share some of these memories with all of you today.
Dance with
just love that. Thank you, students, so much for sharing those beautiful memories with all of us. I know it's a treat to relive and look at all those things that they've done together and with the staff and faculty here. So thank you for sharing those memories with us. Our ceremony is now coming to a close, and it is my pleasure to announce our VN program coordinator, Tony Cabrera, for a closing statement.
Thank you, Ms. Mathis. First, I'd like to say thank you to families for coming and to the students. I just want to say right now, they are in an unprecedented time. They went through a pandemic in their education, and I know these students, they have some stories because they actually had Ms. Cabrera when I first started. I've been with this program now for a little over a year, and I had my hands full, and these students, they've made an impression on my heart. They've helped during the midst of the pandemic with vaccines. They've went all over, Porterville, Visalia, Fresno, helping to vaccinate the population in order to help in the promotion of well-being during the pandemic, and we're so proud of them. Each and every one of them have had some family member or some real connection with what's happened through this pandemic, loss of family members, pregnancies, childbirth, right? Everything that they could have ever experienced. And I just want to say thank you to them for embracing me when I came. And I'm so looking forward to this program getting even better and better. The students that we have produced are professional. They are kind. And they are going to give back to the community in such a major way. But one thing I do want to say is this isn't the end. You must continue your education. You must go farther because you are needed. All of you deserve the best. Your family members, your children. I understand what it's like to sacrifice. Some of you I know went through this as a single mother or through the divorce. And you pulled yourselves together, and I commend you for that. I just want to say thank you again for everything. And never forget one thing about nursing, is you are coming and saying, I want to be a servant. I want to serve. Serve first. Serve people, and everything else will fall into place. Always be about people. Serve. Never forget that. Thank you.
I want to thank you so much for being here today to support these nursing students up here. They still need your support as they go out and sit for their boards. Some of them have already sat for their boards, and I want to thank you. Thank you to the family members. Thank you to the support that you have given them. Let's give the family a round of applause. Thank you. It's not easy to go through nursing school, and I'm sure you've heard them discuss that. I'm sure their social media posts say that too, but you were there, and we really appreciate that. Our ceremony is now coming to an end, and I want to thank you again. I can't thank you enough. I hope you have a wonderful day. I hope you go out and celebrate today, celebrate them and the work that they have done and accomplished over this year. Thank you so much.
Is right, 'cause I'm